Hey, it's me, Ajutski, and today we are predicting what will happen in Sonic Prime Season 2. Before we start that, though, I will have to ask you to please like and sub, as it really helps out the channel. We just hit 153 subscribers, so let's go with that. Thank you all. Let's hopefully get to 200 subscribers pretty soon. Now, before we start, though, there is something else we need to do, and I'm going to go over my thoughts on Season 1 of Sonic Prime and gave a basic overview of what I think Season 2 will be like. With that being said, let's hop right into the video. So to start off with, I think it might be a good idea to go over my basic thoughts on Season 1 of Sonic Prime, or basically half of the first season of Sonic Prime, since Netflix is just kind of cheap and don't want to actually, you know, put forth a second season until they know it's profitable. So in all honesty, this might shock a lot of people, but I didn't really like Sonic Prime Season 1 that much, to be honest. It wasn't as good as I thought it was going to be, and I was kind of let down. I mean, to be honest, from day one, I was really worried about the show. I thought the animation looked kind of just cheap and mediocre, and to some extent, I was wrong. I mean, the animation at points was pretty good, but it was clear that this show was unbelievably low budget and didn't have as much time or effort as I thought had been put into it as I originally thought there was. I mean, in all honesty, I think it's kind of a bad sign when, like, months into production, they're having people come into the show way late on, and it's clear they're really just stretching these episodes as thin as possible. There's so many flashbacks to the early episodes, to the point where it's kind of absurd. Like, honestly, it's crazy how much they stretch these episodes out as much as they can. Now, that's not to say that there's nothing but bad things about Sonic Prime. There are a few things that it does better than any other show, and honestly, this is definitely the best Sonic show ever. Now, you might be wondering, what do I mean by that? Well, let's go through a little example list. I don't know how to put this. Let's just hop into what I'm about to talk about. You see, bar none, this is probably the best Sonic show to ever come out. And you might be wondering, well, what do I mean by that? There's clearly been better shows out there. I mean, there's Sonic Sad AM, Sonic Boom. Some people really like Sonic X, but in all honesty, those aren't good because they're Sonic shows. I mean, Sonic is just kind of a thing in those shows, to be honest. Okay, let's start off with Sonic Sad AM, okay? Now, Sonic Sad AM is a really good show, okay? There's no denying that it's a good show. It's very well written, the animation is pretty good, and the acting is quite superb. Everything about that show is pretty great, okay? However, I would not say it's a very faithful Sonic adaptation, especially since there wasn't really much to go off of at the time, but even the stuff that there was, it just chose not to take from. For example, there's nothing like any Sonic levels at all in the actual show itself. It's very standalone. Most of the characters are not very in character, even how they were portrayed at the time. Like, Tails is basically just a little kid, and Eggman is not at all the way he was portrayed. Even in the West, he was a lot more cartoony and wasn't meant to be taken as seriously as he was in the show. I would say the only character that is in character for most of the show is Sonic, and even then, he's not very Sonic-y. He doesn't have a lot of the tropes, you know. He's not all about adventure. He's kind of a homebody, actually, which is kind of weird to think about. You know, he's actually kind of one of the worst characters in the show, to be honest. Like, if you go back and rewatch Sonic Sad AM right now, he'll have you cringing the most out of every character. Like, I went rewatched a couple episodes just for this video alone, and I gotta be honest, he made me cringe so many times. I'm not even joking. And then there's Sonic Boom, alright? And I like Sonic Boom as much as the next guy, alright? But let's not lie to ourselves, okay? Sonic Boom barely has anything to do with Sonic. In fact, I would say it's basically Seinfeld with a Sonic coat of paint. It's funny, but it barely has anything to do with Sonic, especially not even Sonic Boom, which is what it's based off of specifically. I mean, there's important characters in the Sonic Boom game like Cliff, and they don't make an appearance in the show, like, at all. And they're, like, an integral part of the game, so I don't know why that's... I don't even know why it's a Sonic Boom specific to begin with. I mean, I guess it was a marketing tactic or whatever, but really, it barely has anything to do with Sonic Boom, let alone Sonic in general. Then there's Sonic X, okay? And Sonic X is definitely probably the most, like, genuinely faithful reinterpretation of Sonic in terms of cartoons and stuff. However, it kind of does them dirty, to be honest. I mean, say what you will about the sound mixing and graphical presentation, but at least it had style. I mean, take the opening from Sonic Adventure 2, okay? You know, he jumps out of the helicopter, it's cool, it's epic, you know, he rides down the streets of San Francisco, it's awesome, alright? But in Sonic X, it's just kind of dumbed down. The cool line that he uses about the airplane movies and stuff like that, it's not even in the show. They don't play any of the music or anything from the games. There's no, like, genuine, like, reinterpretations of iconic Sonic levels. Not even the ones that are they're supposed to be representing, and they don't even do that. I mean, I'll give them this, though. At least they tried. Other shows in the past didn't even care at all. So in terms of representation of the Sonic franchise as a whole, I think Sonic Prime does it so much better than everything else. They get the style right, they get the action right, they get actually a bit of the story right, not so much interpreting past Sonic stories, but like making their own, and one that I could see Sega and Sonic Team as a whole actually coming up with. I could genuinely see them coming up with something pretty similar to Sonic Prime, so I think it does a lot right. It gets the tone right, it does so much more right than Sonic X ever wished it could have, and probably ever attempted to. They actually do a lot of cool reinterpretations of Sonic, like, past levels. Like, New York City is kind of a weird reinterpretation of Eggman Land, and I love that so much. Also, it's kind of cool the way they do Green Hill Zone. I guess that's about all I have to say on Sonic Prime as a whole, at least the first season. I think it's really pretty, kind of a mixed bag, but there are some good things to it. Anyways, let's hop on to my predictions about Season 2. Now, my first major prediction is that I'm pretty sure they're gonna try and finish up Sonic's character arc from Season 1. Now, if you don't know what I'm talking about, in Season 1, early on, he doesn't really appreciate his friends very much, up until he meets these other versions of his friends. For example, 9 is kind of a weird reflection of Tails. And every time Sonic is around 9, all they can think about is regular Tails. That relates to basically every other, you know, alternate version of his friends from each different dimension that he travels through. Another theory of mine is that this might be actually kind of like a buddy kind of season with Shadow. Like, I feel like the rest of Season 1 or Season 2, as they're advertising it, will be kind of just a team up between Sonic and Shadow, you know, figuring out all these different dimensions and stuff. A thing I have noticed too is that they haven't actually shown any alternate dimension versions of Shadow either, and I wonder if that'll ever be brought up anytime soon in this second season. Another little side theory of mine is that the reason we haven't seen any alternate versions of Sonic or Shadow is because they were the ones who may have outran it, or might have inadvertently caused it. I think Shadow is just as guilty as Sonic in some respects, and I think that's the reason we haven't seen any alternate versions of him yet. Of course, that's just a theory, but it seems pretty plausible. I really think that Shadow has a lot more to do with the smashing of the little stone thing than we're being led on to believe. I think he genuinely has something more to do with the story than we've seen so far. I also think at one point we might have Shadow actually explain what everything happened from his point of view before the shard broke to Sonic, which I think would be really interesting, and it'd kind of be dumb if they didn't decide to take advantage of having Shadow as a main player in the story, which I'm 98% sure he will. Another prediction of mine is that Shadow will also get some new fancy shoes, and you know the little doohickey that goes on Sonic's shoes, right? That's basically what I'm trying to say, is that Shadow's gonna get one of those too eventually. In fact, I think eventually a lot of Sonic's friends will inherit those over time, especially if there is like a third season, since I'm 98% sure the series like main storyline will get wrapped up after the second season. So I'm pretty sure they'll do something where all the characters, you know, get little cool add-ons. Also, there is the question of how will this relate to the games as a whole, because clearly everybody and their grandma has pointed out the fact that this really doesn't seem to like correlate with the Sonic video games at all, despite Sega claiming themselves that this does take place in the same timeline as the games. That's basically all the theories I have for this video and just general predictions. I guess that really just leads me to my conclusion. In conclusion, while I don't personally love Sonic Prime as much as other people, I do see why people would, and I do think Season 2 has a lot of great possibilities and a lot of interesting writing things, although I don't completely agree with some of the ways they've taken certain characters in certain directions. I can understand why they did what they did, and I can appreciate it a lot more. And while I don't agree with everything that they've done, I can truly say this is definitely the best Sonic show we've ever seen, at least to this point so far. That's pretty much all I have to say for this video overall. This was actually a fan-requested video in one of my last video's comments. If you guys have any other suggestions for videos, tell me about it in the comments below. That's pretty much all I have to say for this video, though. Thank you all for watching. It was Amiya Jetski, and I will see you next time. Buh-bye.